Hey guys, so my videos about motorcycles got a lot of attention in the States. I decided to make my first video in English, better say American. Excuse me, so my English is not good enough for you, but I try and I would like to get any kind of response. So, what we are talking about here is a motorcycle that won't start after the winter. Usually, we should disassemble the battery, take the battery out for the winter and charge it in different times. But a lot of us forget. And so here I show how to start a motorcycle. The first try is with a jump start cable and a second battery. And there won't be an effort. It's also difficult to connect the cable of a car jump start to the terminals of a motorcycle. But however, it could be one way. Important is always connect the plus connector first and then mass or minus, because if you would do with a plus cable and shortcut to the mass, the metal of the motorcycle, there wouldn't be a closed circuit. So no short circuit, no spikes, no damage. What we are seeing here is, most of you will know, a Honda Shadow with 600 cubic centimeter. So still no effort. The starter is turning, but it won't start. No good idea. Here you see how you shouldn't do it. The mass, the minus is connected and you are manipulating with the plus cable. That's no good idea. Always disconnect first of all the minus cable. So here we go again with check out if there is a spark plug. No, stop, correction. First of all, we try with some fuel in the manifold of the carburetor. The idea is that may the carburetors won't support with fuel, with vaporized fuel, may choked a jet or the float is hanging or whatever. I've been surprised by the lot of viewers for my video about the Kahin carburetors, and so my skills of Blender 3D raised. I will try to make a video about how these carburetors really work. But back to our actual problems here. Next try. Okay, even with a spraying of gasoline, it won't start.
Gott, geht mir das auf die Eier.
So the next we do now is check out if there is a spark at the spark plugs. This is may not the really appropriated tool for the spark plug, but it works. As you see, the spike plug is wet at the electrode. I think you say electrode in America too. Now we connect the spike plug to mass, and as you see, there was enough fuel in the combustion chamber from the effortless starting attempt, and by blowing it out through the hole of the spark plug, it ignited. So even you won't see a very good spark at the spark plug. There must be one, so it wouldn't ignite. So don't try to clean a spark plug by with a brush. Not doing that, but you're scratching the ceramic isolator, and you will destroy the spark plug. Just burn it out, maybe by a lighter. Or something else, burn it, maybe a bit longer than me. So, next test, will there be a spark plug? A spark. And there is none visible. Bring the spark plug back into the cylinder head. May use a bit of graphite. I think you say graphite in the States too. Don't use oil, because the oil will burn by the temperatures, and the unscrewing of the spark plug will become difficult. So at this point, I decided to disassemble the battery, to take the battery out, and charge it. Before we took a look at the spark plug of the other cylinder, the front one. With our not optimized tool. this one is wet too. And it needs an ignition system in very good condition to produce a vital, a visible spike at this wet spike plug. Same procedure, connect it to the metal of the bike, and I would recommend to use a, how do you say, handcuff? No, okay, to protect the hand, cause, and take care to maintain a permanently contact to mass. Otherwise, the spike would go to mass through your hand, and that don't feel very nice. So putting the spike plug back. Same procedure. And tighten it. Not too much. Careful, this is aluminium alloy, and the threads will be vulnerable. I put the hand on the intake manifold in a hope to suck a bit of fuel out of the carburetors, but it was effortless, like you see. So now we start to disassemble the battery. By this way I discovered that the plus terminal wasn't tightened very not too carefully. It was loosened, so I understood why I sometimes had start such problems. The pre-owner very carefully. Now, before we get to the battery, we must loosen these two screws. I think it's a fuse or something like that. But anyway, it must unscrewed, must disassembled for a free access to the battery. The same procedure here. Start with disconnecting the minus terminal. So if you would touch with your screwdriver the metal of the bike, there wouldn't be no shortcut, because you're connecting minus and minus. Elsewhere, you would do a shortcut. Here I test. It's a simple test of what's about the battery. There should be a little spike, but there is nothing. No spike, so battery is absolutely low and should be charged. At this part of the video I almost had... Looks like I had disconnected the minus terminal. I must correct myself. What I showed was the disconnecting of minus terminal, and now I disconnect the plus. It's important to disconnect minus first, so you can pull the battery far enough out to reach the plus terminal. And here we got it. It's battery charger. You can adjust a constant current, makes it easier. So nine ampere hours would mean charging it with half an ampere would be a half an ampere hour per hour. So after 18 hours it will be full. This was a little help. This was an idea from me to fixing the counterparts of the bolts, the threads. So it makes it a lot easier to fix the screws, because these parts won't come loose during the fixing of the battery. So here we go, putting the battery back. The plus terminal connecting first, so you can't make a shortcut with your tool. Make sure to have to use a screwdriver long enough, because in other case you won't reach the bolt. Okay, I stop here with my comments and be surprised what happens. If you like my video, it would be nice to get a thumb up. And if my English is not so good at any places, please comment in kind and tell me how to improve. Thanks a lot and always drive safe with your motorcycle.